हेलो चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 5 एंड 6 ऑफ क्लास 8 सब्जेक्ट हिस्ट्री। चैप्टर 5 1857 इंडियाज फर्स्ट फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल। चैप्टर 6 बीवर्स आयरन स्मेल्टर्स एंड फैक्ट्री ओनर्स। सो ऑल ऑफ यू चिल्ड्रन टेक आउट द पेज नंबर 61। ओके, नाउ प्रैक्टिस टाइम। टेक द करेक्ट आंसर्स। फर्स्ट वन, हु वॉज द प्रोमिनेंट लीडर इन लखनऊ ड्यूरिंग द रिवॉल्ट ऑफ 1857? इट इज बेगम हजरत महल। विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज वन ऑफ द सोशल रीजन्स फॉर द 1857 रिवॉल्ट? आंसर इज बोथ ए एंड बी। द रिवॉल्ट ऑफ 1857 स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम? इट इज मेरठ। After the revolt of 1857, the British began to follow the policy of divide and rule. Fill in the blanks. The British East India Company has established its presence in India in 1612. The different section of Indian society expressed their indignation through protest and revolts. The rebellion is known by many names including dash dash and dash. They are Sepoy, Mutiny, Sepoy Mutiny. Next is Indian Mutiny and Great Rebellion. Okay, and Revolt of 1857 Indian Insurrection First War of Indian Independence. Next, fourth one, the abolition of the monopoly of trade in 1833 of East India Company and introduction of free trade increased further the exploitation of peasants. Dash meant that if Indian military personnel were posted abroad, they wouldn't title to get extra allowances. Answer is general service enlistment. Sixth, Dash ordered another Indian soldier to arrest Mangal Pandey. General Hersey. In 1801, a subsidiary alliance was imposed on Bengal. False. The British had to fight for 2 years to suppress the massive force of the rebellions. True. The proportion of Indian soldiers were increased after the revolt. False. The rule of India came directly under the British crown after the revolt. True. In 1805, a new law was passed to make the conversion to Christianity easier. False. Match the columns. Nana Saheb, Kanpur. Kunwar Singh, Bareilly. खान बहादुर। सॉरी, कुंवर सिंह इज़ फ्रॉम बिहार एंड खान बहादुर इज़ फ्रॉम बरेली। अहमदुल्ला लखनऊ, सुरेंद्र शाही उड़ीसा। नाउ आंसर दीज क्वेश्चंस इन वन लाइन ईच एंड 4 to 5 lines ईच, डू इन कॉपी द आंसर्स आई विल बी शोइंग यू। ओके चिल्ड्रन, नाउ फर्स्ट आंसर इज द ब्रिटिश फॉलोड द पॉलिसी ऑफ रेशियल डिस्क्रिमिनेशन एंड लुक डाउन अपॉन द इंडियंस। Indians were not allowed to travel in first class compartment in trains. List some. Second is Ahmadullah, Nana Saheb, Rao Saheb, Tatya Tope, Rani Lakshmibai, Kunwar Singh and Firoz Shah were some of the new leaders that came to the forefront during the War of 1857, Revolt of 1857. Next, Mangal Pandey's answer is Mangal Pandey was an Indian soldier who played a key part in the events immediately preceding the outbreak of the Indian Rebellion of 1857. He was sepoy in the 34th Bengal Native Infantry Regiment of the British East India Company. Answer number 4th. Mutiny refers to the forcible or passive resistance to lawful authorities. The Revolt of 1857 was known by the various names such as the Sepoy Mutiny, the Indian Mutiny and the Great Rebellion, the Indian Insurrection and the First War of Independence. Answer 5. The expansionist and annexionist policies of the British government, prohibition of Indian religion, customs and resumption of tax-free land and confiscation of jagirs. 6th one. When the Raja of Jhansi, without a biological male heir, in 1853, Jhansi was annexed to the British Raj under the doctrine of lapse. His widow Rani Lakshmibai, the Rani of Jhansi, opposed all this and protested against the denial of rights to their adopted son. This was the reason behind Rani of Jhansi joining the uprising. Next, answer in 4 to 5 lines. First one, economic cause. Resumption of tax-free land, confiscation of jagirs, high land revenue and strict policy of collection, British good exempt from duties in India and heavy custom duty imposed on Indian goods in England, decline of artisans and craftsmen due to unfair competition. Political causes, expansionist and annexionist policies of the British, the nobility lost their titles and domains under the doctrine of lapse. The native rulers were forced to disband their armies. Second, main reason for the failure of the revolt. The sepoys lacked a common idol before them. The orthodox section among the Hindus and the Muslims were concerned. Only with their respective religion, the rebellion lacked an effective leader. The rebels lacked resources in terms of man, money and equipment. What were the grievances of the sepoy against the company? Grievances of the sepoy against the company is the Indian military was not professional military. They were just peasants in uniform. Thus, every impact on peasantry had large repercussion in the form of military discontentment, the wearing stances of the British government, reduction of allowance and harsh punishment contributed to a feeling among the sepoy that the government did not care a trifle for them. Increased recruitment of Sikhs and Gurkhas, who were considered by the Bengal sepoy to the inferior in caste to them, increased the distrust of the sepoy. The Indian military was discriminated against in terms of salaries, pension and promotion. Acts such as the General Service Enlistment Act, which meant that if the Indian soldiers served abroad, they would not be entitled to get extra allowances, and the Religious Disabilities Act, which meant that it was compulsory for the Indian sepoys to serve abroad, even when they considered this as a branch of their religion, further increased discontentment among the Indian soldiers. Fourth one, after effect of the revolt, the rebellion saw the end of the rule of the East India Company in India and its powers were transferred to the British Crown. A new government department called as the Indian Office was created to handle governance of India, and its head to the Secretary of State for India was entrusted with formulating the Indian policy. The Governor General of India took the title of the Victoria of India, and he was entrusted with implementing the policies formulated by the India Office. Queen Victoria took the title of the Empress of India in 1877, and she assured that the rulers of princely states that the government would not interfere in their internal matters and the social and the religious beliefs and traditions of common people. Doctrine of lapse was withdrawn and titles and humours was granted to rulers in order to befriend them. The Indians were drawn into a government at local level in a limited manner. Universities were opened in various Indian towns. The British increased the ratio of British to Indian soldiers with India. The British now followed the policy of divide and rule in India. Fifth one, immediate cause of the revolt of 1857. The immediate cause of the revolt of 1857 was the introduction of the Enfield rifle, because it was believed that the cartridge of the Enfield rifle had been bitten off before use, but its cartridge was made up of pork and beef. The Hindus worship a sacred animal like sacred animals like cow, and the Muslims could not consume pork as they thought it to be impure. So the introduction of Enfield rifle had upset the feelings of the Hindus and Muslims, which were a major of the Indian population. They were against it. Sixth one, the revolt of 1857 ended the rule of East India Company in India. Now the governance of India was transformed to the British Crown. A new government department called as the Indian Office was created to handle governance of India, and its head, the Secretary of State for India, was entrusted with formulating the Indian policy. The Governor General of India took the title of the Victoria of India, and he was entrusted with implementing the policies formulated by the India Office. Queen Victoria took the title of Empress of India. Now we are going to complete chapter number 6. So children, open page number, just open the page 68. Okay, now on page number 68 there is the practice time given. You are going to write the answers for this practice time. So the first one, the first cotton mill in India was established in Bombay. Spot from the list given below the important handspun material which Mahatma Gandhi urged the people to use. Khadi. The act was passed in Britain to ban the import of the printed cotton cloth into England. It is Calico Act. By the late 18th century, the dash industry of India had declined considerably. It is textile. Next, fill in the blanks. First one, India was famous for the fine quality of its dash and dash textile, cotton and silk. Second one, the cotton textile which the Portuguese took back to Europe along with the spices came to be known as calico. An act was passed in dash against the import of any of such fabric from India, Persia and China. 1700. British cotton products were successful in Europe markets constituting 40.5% of exports in 1784 to 86. True and false. The invention of spinning jenny and steam engine revolutionized cotton textile weaving in England. True. European trading companies such as the Dutch, the French, and the English purchased cotton and silk textiles in India by importing diamonds. False. Men were usually involved in the work of spinning. False. The Tata Iron and Steel Company began to produce steel after the First World War. False. Match the columns. Caligo and Chintos. It is cotton fabric exported to Europe from India. Quazi and Dawar. It is spinner of merchandise textile industry. Arms Act 1878. Decline of metal working industry. Thomas Nee. It is imported Indian jute to Dandi. Calico Act 1720. Ban on Indian textile imports in UK. Now we are going to do question answers in one line to two and okay. So do in copy. You have to do this work in your notebook. I am giving you the answers. Okay. So see. First one. Full form of TISCO is Tata Iron and Steel Company. It was set up on 26th August 1907. Second. European trading companies, the Dutch, the French and the English made enormous profits out of this flourishing trade. These companies purchased cotton and silk textile in India by importing silver. Third, Indian textile had long been renowned both for their fine quality and exquisite craftsmanship. They were extensively traded in Southeast Asia, Java, Sumatra and Penang, and West and Central Asia. From the 16th century, European trading companies began buying Indian textile for sale in Europe. Fourth one, in 1720, the British government enacted a legislation banning the use of printed cotton textile chintz in England in order to discourage the import of Indian textile. This act was known as the Calico Act. Now, first one. In the 17th century, India had a buoyant export trade including cotton textiles, silk, spices and rice. Indian textiles were banned through the Calico Act of 1720 after the British victory over the Mughal Emperor. Decentralizing of India was done by the colonial policies of the East India Company. During the late 18th and the early 19th century, the Indian industry stagnated and the beginning of the long history of decline in textile exports of India was witnessed. Second, impact of the decline of Indian textile. By the 1830s, British cotton cloth flooded India market. By the 1880s, two-thirds of all the cotton clothes worn by Indians were made of the cloth produced in Britain. Thousands of rural women who made a living by spinning cotton thread were rendered jobless. Handloom weaving continued to exist to some extent because some types of clothes could not be supplied by machines. Machines failed to produce saris and intricate borders or clothes with traditional woven pattern. Many weavers and spinners who lost their livelihood now became agricultural laborers. Some migrated to cities in search of work, and yet others went out of the country to work in plantation in Africa and South America. Some handloom weavers got employment in the new cotton mills that were established in different parts of India. Third one, two factors that led to the decline of Indian textile under the British rule: stiff competition against mill-made goods of England, high tax imposed on Indian cotton goods by the British government and the British goods flooded in the Indian market. Fourth one, factors which led to the decline of mining and metal work industries in India. The British introduced the Arms Act, which restricted the access of the metal to firearms They also sought to limit India's ability to mine and work metals for use in the future. Wars and rebellions in regions such as the metal-rich Rajasthan. As a result, by the early 19th century, most of the mines in Rajasthan were abandoned and the mining caste became extinct. During the company regime, military opponents were alimented and princely states subjugated, and the capacity to mine and work metals declined specifically due to high British traffic. Moreover, mining of lead at Ajmer was perceived as a threat by the British, so they closed the mines. So children, with this we have completed chapter number 5 and 6. You are going to complete your book work in the textbook, and the question and answers of both the chapter are going to complete in your notebook. So complete your work and learn for your exams. Thank you.